So basically, about 5 or 6 years ago, I had, you know, like a friend basically bought a watch mm-hmm. from IWC, and he got a magazine with it. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the magazine, there was a contest.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you had to guess the celebrity. So it was like a full one-page description of the artist, and I had to guess it. So the artist was Charlie Chaplin.
Okay.
Now, my luck with contests is such that I've never even won a balloon in a fair, you know. So I have never won anything anywhere. So I was like, really, should I do this? He's like, yeah, just send it across. What the hell? What does it matter? What's there to lose? Mm-hmm. So I filled it in and I sent it out. About 10 days later, I get a call from an unknown number from someone who had a very weird accent that I couldn't understand. And they said that, oh, you know, hello, Nimrat, we are calling from Schaffhausen. And so that I said, some prank call, I cut it, I said, whatever. I got a call again from them. Mm-hmm. And they actually told me that, listen, please hold on. You have won yourself the first prize of a contest you had filled. And I was like, what? And I actually won an IWC pilot's chronograph,
mm-hmm.
which is my prized possession, because it just... And just a day before that, I was having a conversation with somebody saying that I don't believe in luck.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I don't think so. You have to work hard and this and that. And within a day, I was proved wrong. So I think I've exhausted my luck after that. But it's a very, very special story for me. And I hold on to that watch with everything.
That's...
Time management. Oh my God. I think it has to be theater. Yeah. Because there, you know, what happens is that you're working around timelines,
mm-hmm.
you know, so much so that you're rehearsing for a month and you know that you have to open your show on such and such date.
Mm-hmm.
And when you are rehearsing before the show is about to open on the day
mm-hmm.
or when you're about to perform, if the show has to start at 7 p.m., it will start at 7 p.m. So my army background is very happy with that. That sort of a situation where there are possible
days. Precisely why you're always on time as people.
Yeah, I am. I'm a very, very, very unfashionable that way. I'm always before
time. That's a good thing.
I have to circle venues in my car because I'm just there early and I'm like, I'll be there before the organizers. This is really sad. So.
But that's a really good thing because not a lot of people are always on time.
Yeah,
so.
Well, that ad was super special for me. Firstly, I was filming Homeland at the time in Cape Town, so it was a nightmare for us to try to figure it out. But with fantastic efforts from my team, we could figure it out and we managed to do it. It has been directed by one of my favorite directors, Vivek Kakkar, who also directed other ad films that I've worked in, which have been immensely popular. So this ad in itself was like very, very, very dear to me. The concept was brilliant. It's not about women being aggressive or women being, you know, something that they are not. I think it's just about being self-assured and being happy with the choices that you have made,
mm-hmm.
and not having an apologetic, you know, stance on things that, you know, you have decided for yourself. So I think it was a very, very sweet, self-assured and a very unapologetic space. So I really love that. I don't love reading as much as I should. I think I should read a lot more. I end up reading a lot of scripts and things like that, which doesn't really mean reading because I'm, you know, that's kind of part of my job. But like, I really enjoy playing with my cats a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Or rather, I really enjoy them playing with me, you know.
Mm-hmm.
they're a lot of fun. I have two cats at home. And I love hanging out with my friends and going for movies and plays and just... You know, driving around, I love driving. I do. Even in Bombay, I really enjoy driving a lot. I don't keep a driver. I just love driving so much. So right. Those are the few things I really love doing. Right. Well, I think it's a great privilege to be on that list. There were some legendary stalwarts on that list. You know,
right.
I was like, I don't know if they want to be on this list with people like us. We're just starting out. We've just done like a few years of work and we're just like 1, 2 films old. But it's one for keeps and I'm really very, very, very honored to be on that list.
Awesome.